It's not dead.
Let's head him up.
Woo! With Catchem All Fishing with Zak Catchem.
Look at this fish.
Head him up.
Guys, we're out here. We got a spectator. That's my mom. I'm pretty sure that there's some type of catfish here or a turtle. It could be a soft shell, but if I'm not mistaken, I'm pretty sure it's a turtle. Because this little hole has been like kind of wet for a while. And there's a lot of this coming out from here, and it's like water's pushing up this way, and it seems like there's a hole underneath where this pump is. So I'm pretty sure there's a hole from here to here, and there's catfish breeding in them. I don't think it's a turtle this time, because if it was a turtle, there'd be no reason for all this to be here. If I had to guess, I would guess that there's a big old catfish down here. So what I'm gonna do is first, I'm gonna pour water here and see if it comes out from under this thing. I think there's a hole under there. If there's a bunch of debris and sand like you see here, there's something moving back and forth. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna put this net right here and see if it comes out. You might be able to catch it. Stand right there. So if it's something juts out, then we'll be good. Something juts out. Okay, ready? Let's go right here. Eyes on. You guys ready? Something comes flying out of this thing.
Well, let's do it. Let's see what happens.
You ready? Okay. We got it all together. Hello? I'm pretty sure that there's a catfish in here. I don't think this is a turtle. But if it is a turtle, I'm stuffing my hands in here and I'm making a mistake, but it looks like there's a hole over here. You can see when I put a bunch of water here, there's a lot of clouds from that dust, that debris, that silt that's coming up from that end. So it's leading me to believe that there's a cave from here to here. And a lot of times in the summertime, in the springtime, these catfish come up and they go right inside and they nest and they lay eggs and the eggs come out. And it's probably either a flathead or a walking. But if they come out that way, we may or may not catch them. I'm not sure which direction that hole is, but they usually lay their eggs in really shallow water. Okay. Hello? Hello? Ew, oh my God. There's a mole cricket or something. I don't know. Nothing so far. Nothing? Did we see anything?
No, not at all.
I didn't see anything, huh?
No. Nothing came out under the pump either.
Okay. Still nothing, huh?
Not at all.
We got a lot of little mole crickets coming out though. It's really gross. A lot of little larvae and stuff. That hole goes.
Be careful, buddy.
There's something in there.
For sure?
100%. It sucks because even with the water sunglasses, which are great, and cut through the glare, I can see everything through semi-clear water. This is just mud. You can't cut through like solid objects. I can't see through the bucket, although it's pretty close to x-ray vision. I can't see what's in there. I don't want it to be a turtle and I don't want to get bit. I don't have gloves. I thought this was a catfish. We didn't see any baby catfish come up.
Not at all.
What sucks is that we have all these leaves back here, all these weeds. Come over here for a second. Look at the peacock right here. Can you guys see that? A lot of times when there's a lot of dust clouds and stuff like that, there'll be a lot of fish like tackling something, and the peacocks and the largemouth bass will see that dust cloud and they'll think that they're gonna get a meal. But I didn't see that peacock attacking anything, but I definitely felt something. Let's see if we can get close. Come on. I wonder if there's a stick here. Here we go, baby. Hello. Look how deep that is. Come on. There's a hole. It's a hole that goes all the way down. Without a doubt. That's a hole that has to go that way. And what happened was it probably dug its little cave this way and it imploded with all the rain that we're about to have and that we had yesterday yesterday morning, but it stayed wet, which was weird. And then all of a sudden today it was kicking up and kicking up, and this thing kept having dust clouds in it. That's why we noticed it. My mom was out there feeding the koi, and this thing was starting to feed all this cloudy crap. She came to check the pump to see if it was like stuck in the mud, but something is kicking mud into this pump, and you can see that's what happens. And now our koi pond is probably looking like Louisiana water. Okay. Nothing still?
Nope, nothing. I don't see anything at all. It's just getting softer and softer.
Right here, right here. Check this out. That's not a fin?
Could be.
That's not a fin?
Oh, wait. Poke it. How does that feel to you?
Okay. We got some. You know what?
Oh, we can see it now.
I don't know.
What is that?
Looks like a Placo, actually. If it is a stupid Placo, I'm going to be pissed. Oh, yeah.
Oh, look at that.
Is it alive? Oh, no, that thing's dead. Oh, it's not dead. 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 So, guys, I was right. This is a pair of walking catfish. Now, this is why they're so invasive. They dig holes, just like Placos, everything else, and they lay their eggs, and they can survive, like, forever. This thing could be on dry land forever. Come here, honey. This thing could be... Oh!
Nice catch. Oh.
This thing could be on dry land forever. Now, I think I might have imploded this hole, or I made it kick up a lot of extra crab. It's a pretty big one, guys. That's a pretty big one. He still has a lot of energy for having that whole thing imploded on him. And that's why they're so invasive. Come here. Oh! Come here, sir. You can lip these things. Check that out. Look at this little guy. Look at that thing's mouth. How weird is that? They eat everything. Here, I'll bring it to you. Zoom into that thing. Look at that little thing's mouth. It's just a little catfish. But these things are super invasive. Super invasive. Hasn't been caught. No hook holes. And that's a championship winning walking catfish right there. You can release it once you catch it immediately, but these things have been plaguing my koi pond. I'm trying to have babies. So unfortunately, this guy shall be a red tail sandwich. We might have to chop a little chunk of him to feed it to the pocket. Oh, no crap. Feed it to the pocket. But there you go, guys. Keep on pouring water, will come out of that cave.
That was weird, bro.
It's pretty cool, huh? Not too bad. But if you see any type of like little land that looks like it's a little imploded, that's a little bit more wet, as you guys saw before, it was just a little bit wet. It was like pumping up water. It seemed like something was trying to get out. It was this thing trying to get out. Now you guys know, walking catfish or Placos, could have been a turtle, but thank God it wasn't. Otherwise, I probably would have been missing one or two fingers. All right, guys, we got to get rid of this guy. This guy will be a red tail sandwich, but all of our koi fish are doing great. But look at this. One little thing, one little tiny fish, and me, I've obviously helped by pouring all that mud in, but it was just as bad this morning. Bomb. Muck and muck and muck, and that's what happens. And along with that comes the baby catfish. So if you don't take care of your little problems, next thing you know, you got more problems, and it's super annoying. But that'll clear up in 10 seconds. Now that this guy is not kicking up all that mud over and over and over again, it'll settle down. And this might be a female. The eggs might have not hatched or might have not been laid. If she was in there, I don't think the eggs were laid. So male or female, either way, one of them, breeding pair, is out. You guys can see, can you see that without, yeah, you guys can see that. There is a nice bed of algae here. Really, really, really nice. Now we have our big old poppy, come on over here. But if you see these guys right here, see them?
Mm-hmm.
Those two little fish, mine and the other cichlid,
yes.
They're super invasive. Even in ponds, I did not put those fish in there. God, those were babies just like this guy. part of the same like cichlid and walking catfish and snakehead stuff. They're all so invasive because they're really small and they can get everywhere and they can survive literally out of water forever. So what we need to do is we need to get rid of our bluegill even that are in that pond because they are killing all of our small minnows. We need to get rid of those guys. Let that tilapia make its little eggs. Look at that guy in the corner, beautiful. And then we'll have a bunch of those beautiful tilapia to go with our pacu because our pacu really shouldn't mess with them too bad. You guys okay? Why don't you go over to Joey? Over to Joey.
Come say hi.
Come say hi.
Come say hi, babies.
Go ahead. Go over there. Click.
Yeah,
it's over there.
It's so big, bro.
Oh my goodness. Bro, I swear that one's longer than the big one. Maybe not.
Close to close.
I think they're close. Yeah, they're pretty close. So I'm gonna take this guy. I'm gonna turn him into fish sticks. But guys, stay tuned for the next episode. You can catch your Waterland sunglasses, the new ones that I made for you guys. Wrap around, no light, full peripheral vision. Polarized lenses, the best of the best that I wear all the time. They will not break on you. These are the best sunglasses of all time. I literally made them exactly for myself, exactly what I want to use to catch fish, so you guys can do the same thing at home. Get your pair, be awesome, catch everything, and post it so I can see it, guys, and catch them all.
Catch them all.
Catch them all.